Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on inverse of a cyclic permutation, what is disjoint cycles, how we are finding out the product of two disjoint cycles in the group theory of discrete mathematics course. In the previous video, we are already discussed about what is cyclic permutation, how we are finding out the order of a cyclic permutation, what is identity permutation, what is the example for identity permutation and cyclic permutation. That can be discussed in the previous video. If anybody wants, please refer that videos in my YouTube channel. Now we can go for what is inverse of a cycle over R, what is inverse of a cyclic permutation with one example problem. Okay, let capital S be a finite set that contains finite number of elements. Sigma is a permutation that can be defined on the elements of set S, and also sigma is a cyclic permutation can be defined on the elements of set S. Then the inverse of sigma can be denoted by sigma inverse, that can be obtained by rewriting the elements of sigma in reverse order. Rewriting the elements of sigma in reverse order, then sigma inverse is called as the inverse of a cycle or inverse of a cyclic permutation. Okay, now consider the example. Let S is equal to set of 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. So S is a finite set that contains finite number of elements. Okay, that is 5 elements. So sigma is a cyclic permutation that can be defined on the elements of set S. So here that is 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is a cyclic permutation. How can you say that this is a cyclic permutation? Okay, here 2 image is 3, 3 image is 4, 4 image is 5, 5 image is 2. Then we can say that it is a cyclic permutation. Okay, so this can be represented in the matrix form as, okay, first we have to write all the elements of set S in the first row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, the second row contains the images of each and every element in the first row. Okay, so here 2 image is 3, 2 image is 3, 3 image is 4, 4 image is 5, 5 image is 2. So whatever the elements that are left in the sigma, okay, image of that element is same element. Here, what is the element that are missing here? 1. Okay, so 1 image is 1. 1 image is same element. That is, 1 image is 1. Okay, so this is the sigma. This is the sigma is the permutation that can be defined on the elements of set S. So from this sigma, how we are writing the cyclic permutation? Okay, so here 2 image, first I am taking element 2. Okay, 2 image is 3, 3 image is 4, 4 image is 5, 5 image is 2. Okay, now whatever the element that is images of same element, that element cannot be written here. Okay, now the inverse of a permutation sigma, cyclic permutation sigma, can be written sigma inverse. Sigma inverse is the inverse of cyclic permutation sigma that can be obtained rewriting the elements in reverse order. Okay, we have to write first 5, after that 4, after that 3, after that 2. Okay, rewriting the elements in reverse order 5, 4, 3, 2. 5, 4, 3, 2. So then sigma inverse is called as the inverse of sigma, inverse of a cyclic permutation sigma. Okay, so then how we are writing the permutation of sigma? First we are writing the elements. Okay, of S in the first order, then second row contains the images of each and every element. Okay, so here 5 image is 4, 4 image is 3, 3 image is 2, 2 image is 5. Whatever the element that is left here, so image of that element is same element. Okay, so here S is a finite set that contains 5 elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sigma is a cyclic permutation that can be defined on the elements of set S, that is 2, 3, 4, 5. The inverse of a cyclic permutation sigma can be denoted by sigma inverse. Sigma inverse can be obtained by rewriting the elements of sigma in reverse order. First we are writing 5, next we are writing 4, next we are writing 3, next we are writing 2. Then sigma inverse is called as the inverse of a cycle sigma, or sigma inverse is called as the inverse of a cyclic permutation of sigma. Okay, now we can go to the definition. Let sigma is a cycle or a cyclic permutation, then the inverse of a cycle, inverse of a cycle sigma is represented by sigma inverse. Okay, sigma inverse is obtained by rewriting the elements of sigma in reverse order. So this is a sigma, this is a sigma inverse, rewriting the elements of sigma in reverse order. Example, if sigma is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 of set S is set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then sigma inverse is obtained by rewriting the elements in reverse order. Okay, first we am writing 5, next I am writing 4, next I am writing 3, next I am writing 2. So this is the simple definition of inverse of a cycle or a inverse of a cyclic permutation. Okay, next we can go for disjoint cycles. Okay, so when we can say that two cycles are said to be disjoint cycles. Okay, so two cycles or two cyclic permutations are said to be disjoint cycles if they do not have any common element. So for example, so S is a finite set that contains 4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so sigma 1 is only 1, 2, sigma 1 is only 1, 2, and sigma 2 is 3, 4. Okay, so sigma 1 and sigma 2 are two cyclic permutations defined on the elements of set S. Here sigma 1 and sigma 2 are said to be disjoint cycles if they do not have any common element. Okay, sigma 1 is contains 1 and 2, sigma 2 contains 3 and 4. So sigma 1 and sigma 2 do not have any common element. Hence we can say that sigma 1 and sigma 2 are two disjoint cycles. Okay, now we can go for the definition. Two cyclic permutations are said to be disjoint cycles if they do not have any common element. Example, let sigma 1 and sigma 2 are two cycles or cyclic permutations of set S is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here sigma 1 is 1, 4, 2. Okay, sigma 2 is 3, 5. Okay. So sigma 1 and sigma 2 cycles do not have any common element. So sigma 1 is 1, 4, 2, sigma 2 is 3, 5. So here sigma 1 intersection sigma 2 is equal to 1, 4, 2 intersection 3, 5. Okay, there is no common element between them. So then sigma 1 intersection sigma 2 is equal to 5. So whenever sigma 1 intersection sigma 2 is equal to 5, then we can say that sigma 1 and sigma 2 are two disjoint cycles. Okay, so this is the description about disjoint cycles. Now we can go for product of disjoint cycles.